Hello and a very warm welcome to Saurasar classes. Today's tutorial will be on ISLM model. In case of any query, you can contact us on this particular number. And if you want to know more about us, you may visit our website. Now, in our previous tutorial, we are already done with part A and B. So today we will be concentrating on part C. So here we need to show that using the ISLM model setup, we have to comment on interest rate, income, consumption and investment if government increases taxes. Now, in the figure given below, I have taken R and Y on the two axes. I have actually drawn a negatively sloped IS curve and a positively sloped LM curve. Now let us first write the equation of these two curves. So IS curve is written by C0 C1 Y, which is nothing. This is the autonomous part of consumption function. This is the induced part, which is the MPC, plus the investment function. So this is for IS equation, and at equilibrium this happens IR, and this is G, okay? And this Y can also be rewritten like Y minus T plus IR plus G. This is the IS equation. And if we want to write the LM equation, it will be, so for LM, it will be something like this. For LM, the real money balances demanded is a function of interest rate and income. And at equilibrium, the demand for real money balances should be equated to the supply of real money balances. Okay, so if we want to increase tax, or if the government is increasing tax, we need to find out first which curve will get affected. Now, if you look at the IS equation and if you look at the LM equation, you can clearly see that this particular part is fixed, the supply is fixed. In the demand part, we can see it is a function of interest rate and income. So LM curve will definitely not be affected. So this is out of our sight. But in the IS equation, we can see there is a tax component T. So definitely IS curve will be affected if there is an increase in tax. So let's see. So now, if the tax increases, here the tax is increasing. So T comes with a negative sign here. So definitely this entire value will fall. So IS curve will be shifted downwards. So let us shift the IS curve downwards. Okay. So if this is IS2, this is your new Y2, R2, and let me mark the initial equilibrium level of output level, and equilibrium interest rate. So, and the extent of shift or now we need to calculate by how much Y is changing. They have not asked us, but still we will be calculating this. So in order to calculate this, if you know or if you have any idea with regard to what is tax multiplier, you already know the value by which Y would increase, or Y would change rather. Sorry, it will fall in this case, and it will change by an amount given by. So del Y will be minus MPC by 1 minus MPC into del T. Okay, so this will be the change, or by the value by which Y will fall. Okay, now we need to comment about interest rate, income, output, etc. So we can see in this particular that interest rate has fallen, okay, and income level has also fallen. So let us write this. So R falls from R1 to R2, and because investment and R are inversely related, investment will increase. Okay, so we have commented on two components. One is interest rate and investment. Then Y also falls from Y1 to Y2. Now, because this Y falls, that means the disposable income. See, Y minus T, this value has actually fallen because T has increased. Now, if this is nothing but our disposable income. So, if this falls, that means disposable income fall. And because consumption is related to disposable income, our consumption in this case will also fall. So, I hope this tutorial was helpful. If it was, please hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.